As is usual every year, the Grand Master of the Order of Malta delivered his speech to the diplomats accredited to the order. It's when this humanitarian organization reviews the global situation and examines how it helps to alleviate the suffering caused by 36 open conflicts that are ongoing throughout the world. One of their projects is their work in Iraq after the end of the Islamic State.
In order to facilitate the return and reintegration of displaced communities in the Nineveh Plains in northern Iraq, our international relief agency, Malteser International, is rebuilding houses and schools.
In the Middle East, the order's support of both Christians and non-Christians is not only a way of improving the lives of a population that have faced armed conflicts for years, it's also a message of coexistence. For example, in Bethlehem, they work side by side with Christian and Muslim personnel in this health center. Additionally, in Lebanon, due to the overwhelming amount of refugees from Syria and Iraq, the order runs 10 ambulatories and 4 mobile clinics.
This program aims to meet the needs of both the refugees and their host communities, enabling the two groups to build stronger social and cultural links and to promote social cohesion.
The order staff and volunteers assist wherever a human being needs help, regardless of race, creed, or nationality. Whether it's helping migrants risking their lives in the Mediterranean, or Venezuelans seeking refuge in Colombia, or even the Rohingya minority in Bangladesh.
In Bangladesh, relief teams manage 3 medical centers in the refugee camps for this persecuted minority, providing health care, food for starving children, and psychosocial support.
The order maintains diplomatic relations with 108 countries of the world, as well as with dozens of first-class international institutions. With all, there's a single objective: to console and help in the midst of the worst of tragedies.